Welcome to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Super Talk Mississippi 93.7 Spotlight is on Northwest Community College, and you can listen to our live stream at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Here's your host, Gary Darby.
Time to open up September with a Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. It is Thursday, September the 1st. Welcome to the LitgoMetals.com studio and the program today. What is happening on the show? Well, we'll have a little news to get to here at the top. We'll also then get a chance to talk with Karen Brown again. She's with the Sycamore Arts Council in Senatobia. There is an art exhibit coming up on the Northwest campus we need to speak on. It comes up in just a couple of days. So Karen will join us. So tell us all about that. When that interview is done, we'll check in with the head football coach of the fourth-ranked Northwest Rangers, Benjy Parker. His team opens up against Gulf Coast. We'll give you all the details of that. Chat with Coach Parker. We'll chat with Karen Brown. We'll give you a good Thursday show and then get you ready for the rest of what should be an exciting and fun day. Little tidbit of news for you golfers out there, and you've heard us talk about the 2+2 scholarship before. It helps with Northwest Community College and the University of Mississippi at the DeSoto Center. There are a handful of spots that remain for the 16th annual 2+2 scholarship golf tournament. Little help from Bancor South and North Central Electric Cooperative with this golf tournament that's coming up for Thursday, September 15th. So that's when the 2022 tournament will take place at Cherokee Valley Golf Club. Entry fee is $100 per person, $400 for a team. That gives you the greens and the cart fees, a goodie bag, beverages, breakfast for the morning flight, lunch for all participants. And you can choose to start at 8 or at 1, depending on space. And as I've heard, space is running out. The money raised through this tournament funds the 2+2 scholarship initiatives for scholarships at both schools. And the tournament gives first, second, third place prizes. There's a putting contest, closest to the pin, longest drive. You've played one of these things, you know. Complimentary range balls prior to the tee off. Limited team space, so they're looking for sponsors. And if you want to find out more, northwestms.edu is a place you can go and find that information. But the 2+2 Scholarship Golf Tournament comes up in 2 weeks on Thursday the 15th. You can choose to start at 8. You can choose to start at 1. Depends on what you want to do. $100 per person, $400 per team. Get it together because limited space available in that tournament coming up to help raise money for scholarships in the DeSoto County portion of the Northwest world. I mentioned football. I'll mention it again because we'll talk with Coach Parker in a little bit. But you're invited to tailgate there in Senatobia. This message goes to the alumni as starting at 5:30 and going until there at Bobby Franklin Field. It's look for the alumni tent and you can tailgate with the people there. They've got a great setup and all kind of things that have been added to the facilities and things. And I'm probably going to try and get Coach Parker to talk about that before I get done, because I have had an opportunity to be on that campus a couple of times with other sporting events and different things and watching construction and watching things that are going on. They've really built things up nicely in and around really the entire campus, but around Bobby Franklin Field, it's grown. They're new buildings, they're new things, and you're invited to tailgate tonight in Senatobia. It starts at 5:30, goes until whatever time that game gets done with Northwest and Gulf Coast. Rangers ranked number 4 in the country preseason. Gulf Coast receiving votes in the top 25. Of course, these two teams met each other a few times. Rangers beat them in the COVID season to win the championship. And then Northwest saw them in the regular season a year ago. They get them again. They open it up tonight. Bobby Franklin Field, the kickoff for the Rangers and Mississippi Gulf Coast. We'll tell you more about times and all the other things we need to get to as the show goes along. It's 9:13. We'll take a break, and Karen Brown is on the other side. She's with the Sycamore Arts Council in Senatobia. We'll get some information on an exhibit coming up on the Ranger campus next.
You're listening to the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, your connection to Northwest Mississippi Community College on Super Talk Mississippi 93.7. and stream live at supertalknorthms.com. Just click on the link for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hours, we open up September. Coming up in the second portion of the show, the Northwest football team gets started. They're currently preseason ranked number 4. The head coach, Benjy Parker, will talk about his team and tonight's game against Gulf Coast. But we will now bring back a friend that we haven't talked to since January from the Sycamore Arts Council. Karen Brown's on the line. Karen, how are you?
I am doing well. Thank you for asking.
When we had you on in January, it was the Revive exhibit. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about Leave It to Fall. But first, and this has kind of been an arts week for me. Yesterday on my program, I had Wayne Andrews, who's with the Yotnipatawpha Arts Council. He gave us some arts discussion and things going on in his portion of the world. But I want to know what's been going on with the Sycamore Arts Council and how things have been going in Senatobia.
Well, art continues to grow, which is our main goal. Summer is sort of a quiet time for us. We do so much of our effort goes towards education in the schools, arts education in the schools. But we are very excited to start Leave It to Fall. It opens on September 5th and ends on September 30th. It is at the Northwest Community College Gallery. Open to all media. Right now we have between 18 and 20 artists and between 60 and 70 different pieces that we're going to be hanging. Excuse me. Open house is Thursday, September 8th from 5 to 7. And we just invite everybody to come view the different medias of art.
Are most of these people from North Mississippi that we will view the art from?
Most of them are. We have some that are from southern Mississippi. I don't think we have any out-of-staters. We do have some, I don't think we have any out-of-staters this time.
So when we had you on in January, you kind of let us know what Revive meant and where that was with the exhibit. So what is Leave It to Fall?
Honestly, Leave It to Fall is a really good name for an autumn art exhibit. It's just sort of a play on words. It's not an indication of what specific art will look like. But it just seemed to fit with September, so that's what we went with.
So not necessarily will all of the art center around the fall season, but it just was kind of a good play on words and something that was kind of easy. What will we see, though, in the exhibit? What kind of pieces will we find?
Well, we're going to find from all types of media, really. Painting, sculpting. We've got some woodwork coming in, photography, drawing. And it can be abstract. It can be realism. Watercolors, there's just acrylic, anything that's out there. Our artists really are very multi-talented, and they cover all the various types of art and types of media. It's really going to be an interesting show. I think we do have a couple of new artists, at least new to us, that are coming in with their pieces, so we're anxious to display them.
Karen Brown is with us with the Sycamore Arts Council. We are talking with her about an exhibit on the Northwest campus and further events that you can go find that will happen later on involving this arts council at sycamorearts.com. What do you have a favorite medium? What is art? Do you actually do any art yourself? What is it that draws Karen's attention?
I wish I did.
I'm the same way.
I am not an artist, and I guess I have just learned to appreciate different types of art. I don't know. My likes for art are very eclectic, and normally I like more subdued colors, but it seems like as I'm getting older, I like some of the louder stuff. So.
Nothing wrong with that. Absolutely nothing wrong with that. If you don't mind, before we let you go and get out of here with this portion of the show, can we tell the people again when and where to be to see this exhibit on the Northwest campus?
It will be at the Northwest Community College Art Gallery. beginning September 5th through the 30th. Open house is Thursday, September 8th from 5 to 7. And I did want to mention real quickly, in 2023, Sycamore Arts will celebrate their 40th anniversary, which I think is, I think that's pretty outstanding for a little nonprofit to be viable for 40 years.
Do we have big, huge plans for turning 40?
We're hoping to. We're just now starting to talk about them. We're hoping to do something special in the spring. We're doing, we've got other things coming up. We're reopening our gallery on November 5th on Ward Street in Senatobia, and we're working on a mural for Coldwater, which we're excited about that too.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So we've got a lot in the works, and anybody wants to help us, we welcome any suggestions, and we welcome new artists to contact us.
Karen, living in Oxford, there was a mural that was recently painted in the downtown square area, and I saw a little bit of the lady that was doing it, and then came back and saw further, and then now when you see the finished product, I'm amazed at what these people can do. They can have this in their mind. She did this one painting with one color on the wall. I mean, they're wolves on there. There is the Princess Hoka on there. There are different animals, I think a deer and different things. But it's just beautiful to watch and to see. And I think it's great that you're going to try and bring some of that and try and help out the Coldwater area as well. I'm amazed at what people can do. I really am.
I am too. I think that's one of the things that keeps me so interested in it, is that people can take a concept, firstly that they have these concepts.
Right. Yes.
Have a concept in their mind, and then they're able to transfer that from that vision in their mind through their hands and make something that's art just adds so much to the world, I think, and it can bring so much peace to the person who is making it, who is producing it, and to the people who look at it.
Well, I know. I know we've been talking about an exhibit here, but I look forward to the day, as we've mentioned on this program several times, that the Performing Arts Center is up, running, and booming, and we're seeing whatever it is that comes into the city of Senatobia through that venue as well.
Oh, exactly, exactly. And I do want to mention, too, we're always very grateful for the opportunity to put on an exhibit at the Northwest Gallery. Northwest Community College is a great partner of ours, and we enjoy that relationship, and we're grateful for it.
Well, Karen, a pleasure talking with you again. It's been a few months. Maybe it won't be 6 or 7 months before the next exhibit or thing that we need to speak about, but I thank you for your time today.
And thank you.
Karen Brown, she's on the show with us. Hey, coming up next, it's the head coach of the Northwest football team, Benjy Parker. Stay with us on the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour.
This hour is everything Northwest. Your connection to Northwest Community College and powered by Sycamore Bank. Thanks for joining us on the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. Join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
The Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour, we do this on Thursdays. And we're in the second part of our show today, and we'll get a chance to talk to the head coach of the Northwest Rangers, the fourth-ranked preseason football team in the country. Benjy Parker's back on the line and talking with us. Coach Parker, how are you?
Hey, Gary, doing well. Doing well. Thanks for having me.
Sure. We were talking before, you know, actually getting on the air and doing this about being ready for, you know, you as the head football coach of a team getting ready to play your first game, and my broadcasting a few, whether we're ready or not, as you said, we have to be, right? It's kickoff time. It's here.
That's right. It's here, and everybody's excited. You know, as I know, the players are ready to play. I think every coach I know that I talk to, they all, well we need to, we're ready to play, but we don't know if we're ready to play, so. I know the players are ready to play, and actually I'm excited too. We probably need to play, but you know how it goes. I just hope we're ready to play. We'll see, though.
Coach, before I kind of get into some of your team a little bit, if you don't mind, I want to ask you a question about recruiting these days, because I host a show on Monday nights called the Rebel Yell Hotline, and we had Troy head coach John Sumrall on. That's the opponent for Ole Miss on week one. And he kind of got into
transfer portal recruiting and how a school like Troy or other schools are recruiting or still recruiting in the community college world. It's kind of throughout this whole COVID and transfer portal and everything, it's changed everybody's recruiting, hasn't it?
Well, I think it has for the last couple of years for sure, Gary. But in my opinion, you know, it kind of cooled off, if you will, junior college recruiting there for a second. But I think this year, it's going to pick back up like it used to be, and where you'll see a lot of kids sign. I believe that because there's a lot of good players in the JC system and that have been coached the right way and can come in and help them right now. And the coaches know that. It has changed, and I don't think people will shy away from the transfer portal. But I also believe, you know, where they might have a little bit the last couple of years from JC guys, but I think now the JC guys are going to pick back up. And that's kind of what I hear from other coaches that I talk to that come through recruiting and that kind of stuff. So it has changed, but I think it's going to get back to where our kids are, you know, and JC kids all over the country, they'll be recruited hard and heavy here in the near future.
Well, I'm glad you answered that question for us. And I know this, in keeping up with your program and the others in the state of Mississippi, there are plenty of guys that come through this state that are playing on Saturdays, and you've got guys that are playing on Sundays. And so the football here in Mississippi we know is good, and we say that all the time. Coach, offensively, let's look at this version of the Northwest Rangers. I know that you have the receiver in DT Sheffield who returns. He caught for over 1,000 yards last year, but we need a quarterback name. You know, we've got some schools all across the country not putting depth charts out, Coach. Can you lead us into your quarterback situation and what might be going on when your football game gets started?
Yeah, we've got three quarterbacks that have done really well. We've got Cade Barnett, Shade Foster, and Ren Heffley, and all three of those guys have worked real hard and done a great job, you know, throughout the summer and fall camp here since school started. And all three are good players right now. Ren Heffley, he's a transfer kid, has probably separated himself a little bit and probably ahead of the other two guys right now. But the other guys certainly have gave him some competition and pushed him, and that's what we want. And but we feel, you know, real good about all three kids. So right now, our quarterback room looks good. All three are great kids. They're great teammates. They're great students. And proud to have all three of them. But right now, as far as, you know, playing-wise, Ren Heffley's probably separated himself here in the last few weeks.
Coach, I know with you, and I know with, you know, your offensive coordinator, Coach Hill, that you're going to want to run the football too. You've got to do that to do the other things you want in the game. So can you take us into that running back room and the offensive line? And just kind of maybe the run game part of it has to be strong as well.
Well, it does. And you know, if you can run the ball, that's going to set up everything else here. Then you're able to throw, and they, you know, they put another guy down in the box. So you have to throw then. So you're right. And I want to run the ball. But we've got three or four backs that have had a good summer and a good fall camp. Those guys are, you know, got a couple of big guys and maybe a couple of shifty guys, if you will. I think all four of those guys will be good players. The only guy we have returning from last year's team is Jamarian Bracey. He's a big guy. He was number three for us last year, and he's returning, and we're expecting big things from him. He's really matured, and boy, he approaches practice the right way now, and practices hard, and just doing a lot of good things. But yeah, he's the only returning guy we got. And our offensive line, you know, that's, it all starts up front, and We've got two or three guys back that have played a lot of football for us. So we're hoping our offensive line is, you know, can lead a path for those guys to go and protect our quarterback. And so, yeah, you know, we'll see. But I like where we're at right now. I really do. We've got some really smart, tough kids that want to play and want to represent Northwest the right way. So I'm nervous, but I'm certainly looking forward to watching them play.
Sure. I know last year defensively you gave up just a little bit over 21 while scoring 36, and that is something that, you know, in this league you'll be going up against offenses similar to yours that will score a lot of points, and we've got to be able to do something on that defensive side. I know we can't maybe break down position by position or go through it all, but what are we looking like? What do we think on the defensive side of the football?
Well, I think we'll be okay. Those guys have also, again, like everybody else, had a good summer and a good fall camp. So, and, you know, no different on defense. It starts up front also. You know, like I mentioned, you have to be able to run the ball. Well, guess what? On defense, you have to be able to stop the run. So, and it starts with that front seven, and then first and foremost, the defensive line. And we lost a couple of good players, really did, on the defensive line. But we have some guys back that we think are going to be good players, and I'm anxious to watch those guys play. At that linebacker, you know, we lost two guys that were third-year guys and were really good for us, had played a lot of snaps, Michael Campbell, and Colin Robinson. And Michael was from Horn Lake and signed in December, and so Colin was from DeSoto Central and signed in December, and both those guys graduated, proud of them, and they played a lot of football for us. So we lost those guys, so we'll have to find some guys to step up in that position. But And I think they have. We just need to get out there and play. But our secondary, Gary, in my opinion, probably we're the most deep. We're deep at corner, safety. We got a couple, three guys that's coming on, but I really like our four corners that we have.
Coach.
And out of those four corners, all four have played a lot of football for us. So we got some depth there and some older type guys.
I know your answer to this question could be pretty simple and say, Gary, they're going to be good. But what can you tell us about Gulf Coast? You've seen them a lot over the last couple of years, but what can you tell us about the team you're going to play?
Well, here's all I know. They're all, you're right. They always are good. They've got a phenomenal campus and facilities and coaches, and they recruit well. They have a lot of support down there, tradition rich. So we'll have our hands full. I know that. Our guys know that. So I'm anticipating a really good game, a team from Gulf Coast that's going to come in and be hard-nosed and well-coached. And you know, we know that. They always are. They always have been. So we just hopefully can match that. But I'm looking forward to it. You know, we got a great team coming in here, and hopefully there'll be a lot of people here, and I anticipate a great game. So it'll be fun.
Well, there's a reason you're the coach there. There's a reason that people come to Northwest and play football is for these kind of events against Gulf Coast. And I'm glad you mentioned facilities. I had an opportunity to come back and broadcast a lot of the baseball games last season and watch the construction and things going on around Bobby Franklin Field, and coach, the things that are being done for you and for football and really for that entire campus, they're giving some great facilities for you to have and recruit with as well. I can't wait to see the final product of the things I was watching this spring.
Yeah, Gary, I tell you what, our president, Dr. Michael Heindel, the things he's done, you know, in his short time here at Northwest, our campus is growing. It's beautiful. And not only football, man. We just opened a soccer, softball facility. We had a new girls' dorm last year. That's phenomenal. I know there's other projects going on right now, a performing arts center, a new restaurant coming on campus. I mean, he's just done a whole lot of things. And our campus, it's certainly something to be proud of. And we've got great leadership at our college, you know, and he's done a phenomenal job. And we really appreciate it because he knows that is going to attract students. And we really do. We're fortunate. We've got a really nice place. And glad to have him, too, because he wants us to have nice things. And we really appreciate that.
Well, I want to thank you for being on the show this morning, giving us some time. And we wish you the best of luck in this season and another as you get started, ranked number 4 in the country. But that's what you want. You want the expectations to be there. I know that. Coach Parker, thanks for your time.
Thanks for having me, Gary.
We'll be back with more of the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour in just a few.
We're talking Rangers this hour. Thanks for joining us for the Sycamore Bank Ranger Hour. It's a special conversation about Northwest Community College. There's a campus near you and more to come. And you can join the conversation by texting 662-426-1093.
Big thanks to another two great guests on our program. It's 9:45 as we work on this Thursday, September 1. Karen Brown joining us, Sycamore Arts Council. And part of the discussion where coming up next week, you'll have the exhibit, Leave It to Fall. And there'll be all kinds of different things for you to go and see and take part of in the Northwest Gallery beginning next week. And we encourage you to do so. And there are lots of other things that will be going on that campus throughout the month of September that we'll continue to talk about in shows to come. But thanks for Karen and the time today to talk about a little art. And a busy football coach, head man of the Northwest Rangers, Benjy Parker. Number 4 Northwest against Mississippi Gulf Coast, 7 o'clock kick tonight at Ranger Stadium and Bobby Franklin Field. Again, there's tailgating going on. If you're an alum, 5:30 is when they'll start. Get a great opportunity to maybe catch up with some other people that maybe you went to school with or maybe that you'd like to meet along the way. So they'll have that set up for you and all kinds of things going on that Senatobia campus. I would imagine today is going to be a busy one in the city of Senatobia. If you can't make the game, I'll send you to the Ranger sports website, nwccrangers.com, for a couple of reasons. You could keep up with the live stats if you wanted to do that, or you can watch it on Ranger TV. And to do that, it's nwccrangers.com/watch, where a new couple of voices will be with you. Tyler Springs and Gabe Kuhn will be on. And I know Tyler from the time of being with the Memphis Grizzlies. And this has been a while, and I've watched him and his growth as a sports broadcaster. He's done minor league baseball over time. He's done several of the smaller colleges and some high schools in the Memphis area. You're going to like Tyler Springs on the call of the game. And I think eventually I'm going to have him on the program, whether it's on a Ranger Hour or not. We're going to catch up with Tyler along the way, being the new, you know, voice of the Rangers on the television side of things. NWCCRangers.com/watch. You can do that tonight. And, of course, Brian Lentz and his crew will keep up with the stats. They'll have you as informed as they can. And we'll recap what went on in Senatobia tonight. It's game day. 7 o'clock kick there in Senatobia, Ranger Stadium at Bobby Franklin Field, Northwest and Gulf Coast. Lots of things happening on that Northwest campus. We'll try and always inform you of that. Northwestms.edu is a great way to go check it out and see some of the things in the press releases. And let's find out whatever you need. Any of the departments, whatever you have question-wise, it's right there for you at northwestms.edu. In the discussion with Coach Benjy Parker, I didn't get into the fact that, you know, last year they have again, put another MACCC championship together, 11 conference titles in program history, and 3 since 2015, and one of 4 teams that participated in last year's inaugural NJCAA Division I football playoffs. Second year in a row that Coach Parker was named the Region 23 Coach of the Year. And so he has that program up and going, and at number four going into the game tonight. The rest of Mississippi in that top 25 poll, East Mississippi is number six, Hines is number eight, Jones at number 12. Those are the Mississippi schools in the current top 25 with Gulf Coast receiving votes. And the Northwest schedule, as you go, as I mentioned to you, at NWCCRangers.com is there, and you will see a lot of those names that I just mentioned along the way. As when you're in this state, and really it doesn't matter, does it? Whatever the sport might be, and if it's in this community college world or our Division I world or our Delta State and D2 world, or keep going, whatever level you want, football, sports in general, good. And, you know, they take on this Gulf Coast team receiving votes in the national poll tonight. They get Hines, who is nationally ranked next week in Raymond. Pearl River, probably and usually a really good football team as well, are their first three from the south portion of Mississippi. And then they'll step into Itawamba and number six East Mississippi and play, you know, some of the rest of the team. Delta, Coahoma, Holmes, Northeast to finish out the schedule. But a tough one to begin with, tough couple of games to begin with, in fact. And we wish the Rangers the best of luck tonight kicking it off. We will head off into my Thursday and come back and do this again tomorrow. By the way, Brian Lentz, he's on top of things. He sends me the text quickly that says women's soccer won 8-0 at Dyersburg State yesterday, 3-0 on the season, and have outscored their opponents in three soccer matches, 29-0. That's a pretty good start, I would say. They are ranked number 12 in the country in the women's soccer world. We've had Coach Beattie on a couple of times, and just tremendous to hear him speak and talk and how he has built that women's soccer program as well. Thank you, Mr. Bryant. I know you've got a busy day getting ready for some football and all the things that have to happen. Way to shoot that text right in under the deadline. You beat the deadline. Hopefully you've beaten all the deadlines this week, Brian, and you got things ready for what comes up tonight. I've done what I can do here on a Thursday. Welcome to September. It's here, and let's have some fun with it, okay? Thanks for being in all of the various ways you do a part of this program. Talk to you tomorrow, my friend. So long.